was that I wanted to know how you use your like everyday people, how do you make them pose so that they look nice, and how you make use of light when you are posing them, and also how you post process the pictures. And whatever I came expecting here, I have at least learned much more than that, because whatever you had promised, apart from that, we have got much more information, which is like, I think has made me really very happy about this entire workshop.
So honestly, I did not really know what to expect from the workshop, just that I know that Vidhi has excellent portraits on her website, and I just somehow wanted to know that, oh my god, how can I do this? And precisely the reason why I signed up for the website for the workshop was to understand what necessarily goes into portrait photography. Being a wedding photographer, taking portraits of brides, of grooms, of just with people who are not very well dressed or are not appropriately dressed for their body types is the biggest challenge, especially when you're given like 2 minutes, aapke paas jaldi jaldi kaam kijiye. It's the toughest thing to do being a wedding photographer, and posing again is something that plays the biggest part of portrait photography. I think I came here to learn the basic posing tricks and basic tips here and there, but okay, it's nothing what you think it's going to be. It's a lot more, it's vast, it's something all over, it's something new, basically. It's something that's going to change how you perceive a person altogether in front of the camera.
I think the way you position the people irrespective of their body type and what they're wearing, the way you position them in front of the camera, I think that is the main key takeaway for me.
It's about understanding the physique of a person, understanding how you can make anybody and everybody look very flattering. And like they say, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. So that's what you're going to learn if you come for this workshop. More than anything, I think it's kind of taking you back to the basics, where you start. Nobody is going to teach you ki acha camera settings kya kar lo, flash ka settings kya kar lo. But at the same time, you will still be learning a lot of new techniques that you have not thought of, even when they're lying right in front of you.
Portrait photographer for sure, people who want to try out fashion, and wedding photographers definitely. Yes. Thank you.
My biggest challenge was that I cannot, first of all, teach theory.
Mm.
And that's why I kept avoiding the workshop, because I wanted to make it a very practical workshop, because that's how I do. So I just wanted to do the same thing with, you know, the people who are coming here and learning. So that was my biggest challenge, how to make a flow.
Mm.
That, okay, this is how I flow when I am posing somebody. So for me, I never analyzed my own self,
mm.
which I did, I think, during the whole workshop. And making that timeline was a very difficult part for me, and that's why I kept avoiding it. But I think we did okay.
What are the other things that, you know, next workshop you want to touch upon?
First, I think if you come back,
mm.
let's say if you want to do a repeat workshop, then I think you've already got the basics right.
Mm.
But you will definitely go and try all these things, and you're going to find a lot of other things. Because
mm.
right now it was a very fast boot camp.
Mm.
When you start posing people, you will come up with a lot of other issues that you would like to discuss. And that will be a refresher for you. But
mm.
when you have challenges exactly this,
mm.
then you will be able to point it out immediately in the next workshop. Okay.
So after this workshop, when we actually go on a, you know, a live shoot,
hmm.
so what are the things we should keep in mind other than the techniques that we learned here?
I think for you guys the most challenging thing is you don't have everything available with you. I can make different arrangement with settings, you may not have it, but since you have done so many different variations, you would know, okay, if this is available to me, I would be able to do so and so things. For you to keep that presence of mind will be something very challenging. So
right.
with practice, I think you will know what to apply where, which will take time.
Mm-hmm. I think.
I mostly work on Lightroom. Photoshop right. is new to me.
Correct.
Other than some basic corrections, I don't use it much. For me to get the hang of it, I need to ask, you know, many more questions, which takes time.
Right. So that's why I kept that 1 hour refresher, which I felt was very important if I was somebody who was learning.
Mm.
That for me to go apply and then come back to you.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why that 1 hour workshop, you can collect all of these things and come back, and we can still go through. Now you already know everything, so we can still brush up, you know, the small areas where you may have different challenges, you may have different things to ask, and we can go through all of that again. Because no one can actually teach you. Even if I spend 5 days, I may not be able to teach you everything.
Right.
Unless and unless you have that responsibility and pressure alone of directing somebody, making that person comfortable in your space.
Right.
There's nobody to help you.
Mm-hmm.
That thing should happen, then only you'll understand everything. You will still have help here. We are helping each other, but when you're alone shooting someone just by yourself, then I think that will be the time when you'll actually understand.